is a person who wrote the whole history. He made history. He gave such kind of foundations because of whom the whole country is working till today. From poverty to presidentialship, a boy who has seen various things in his life, he lost everything, but then also he became one of the greatest president of the universe, the greatest president of America. Who is he? He is Abraham Lincoln, the 16th president of America. So Abraham Lincoln is one of those America's greatest heroes because of his unique appeal. His remarkable story of the rise from the humble beginning to achieve the highest office in the land, and then a sudden and a tragic death at the time when his country needed him the most to complete the great task remaining before the nation. His distinctive human and human personality and historical role as a savior of the Union and emancipator of slaves creates a legacy that endures. His eloquence of democracy and his insistence that the Union was worth saving embodied. The ideals of self-government that all nations strive to achieve. So we'll look about his early life. So Abraham Lincoln was born on February 12, 1809, in one room log cabin in Larue County. It is in Kentucky, and it is in United States. So Lincoln lost his mother at the age of 9, as it was common on the frontier. Lincoln received little formal education because at that time in the 18th century, there were no facilities with his family. They were quite poor at that time. So he received little formal education. In his young adulthood, he moved with his family to Illinois. It is in Indiana. So he worked as a boatman, store clerk, savior, military soldier, and ultimately a lawyer. So you must be thinking, ye lawyer kaise ban gaye? Inke paas agar formal education hi nahi tha. So we'll look after that in the coming presentation. So how does his political career started? So Abraham Lincoln began his political career and was elected to Illinois state legislature in the year 1834 as a member of Whig Party. This Whig Party was quite famous at that time in the year 1834. So he joined that party, and in the year 1834, he joined Illinois state legislature and became the member of it. And he used to campaign and won at that. And how his political career started, so we have seen this. Now, how does he enter into politics? So he used his term in office to speak out against the Mexican-American War and supported Zachary Taylor for his presidential role in the year 1848. His criticism of war made him unpopular back home, and he decided not to run for second term, but instead returned Springfield. He practiced law. So Lincoln's political revival. What happened in the year 1854 is Congress passed the Kansas-Nebraska Act. Now, what is this Kansas-Nebraska Act? It is the act which was provided by the North. It was provided by the South American Court of Law, and it is that the sovereignty will be decided by the white people. The court decision was that the black were not the part of Americans. So everyone who was with the slavery at that time. Civil war was started in the year 1861 to 1865, but it was among the two states of USA, that is North and South. So North leader was Abraham Lincoln after, you know, when he became the president. Abraham Lincoln and South leader was Jefferson David. In the 1865, North won, and because of the ruthless campaign, the South surrendered. So everyone was with slavery at that time, and that's how the Republican Party came into existence. And Lincoln used to run campaign against the slavery here, candidate for the presidentialship. And everyone was everyone knows that if Lincoln will join the politics, everything will get changed. And the planning started against him here. The series of debates held, there were 7 debates, which was quite famous at that time. It was between Lincoln and Douglas, Stephen Douglas, and, you know, it is famous. And by defeating this, he became the president. Now, Lincoln became the president by defeating these all the hurdles. After he became the president, 7 states seceded from the Union, and it was followed by 4 other states. So Lincoln became the president in the year 1861. And in the general election, Lincoln faced his friend and rival Stephen Douglas, with this time besting him with 4-way race that included John of the North, Democrats, and John Bell of the Constitution Party. Lincoln received not quite 40% of the popular vote, but carried 180 of 303 electoral votes. So these 7 states seceded after, you know, when Lincoln became the president. The South people used to think like, they don't want it to end the slavery. So they eventually made their own union. It was made by Jefferson David, as I've mentioned before. It held in the year 1861. It is just for the slavery. These people did not, these people used to say that the slavery should not get abolished. It will be our loss. And this is how this Emancipation Proclamation Act came into existence. Here, the South was not ready to surrender at that time. It continued with the battles, and finally, Abraham Lincoln started putting the tariffs. Tariffs means the tax on the ships who will go to South from the British countries. So the war started in the year 1861, and the series of battles held over that period, and Abraham Lincoln gave Emancipation Proclamation Act. Guys, Emancipation Proclamation, sunne mein bada bhari word lagta hai, but iska meaning chhota sa hai. It is mukti, azadi. And then he said, we will abolish slavery in the end. Battle of Gettysburg held. It was the last battle which held, and America won. At that time, slavery abolished, but not completely. So Lincoln fought again. They finally ran a campaign to Atlanta, and it was 300 miles away. They killed everyone who wanted slavery. And so the Journal of South, was that? Jefferson, he defeated, and the 13th Amendment came into existence. So what was this 13th Amendment was? It was necessary because the Emancipation Proclamation issued by the President Abraham Lincoln in January 1863 did not end slavery entirely. Those enslaved in border states had not been freed. The proclamation did not address the issue of slavery in territories that would become states in future. So Lincoln and other leaders realized amending the Constitution was the only way to officially end slavery. The 13th Amendment forever abolished slavery as an institution and in all U.S. states and territories. So this is how the 13th Amendment came into existence. And you can see this picture. It's clearly showing this Emancipation Proclamation Act. The people are running over here and there. The system went through. Now, this is how the 13th Amendment came into existence. The 13th Amendment to the United States Constitution outlaws slavery and involuntary servitude. On December 18, Secretary of State William H. Seward proclaimed to it to have been adopted. It was the first of the 3 reconstructions. Amendment adopted after the American Civil War. So after the Civil War, the Reconstruction took place, and it nearly took 12 years to again make it as what America is. After fetching, when I was fetching these informations, I found this beautiful letter, which was written by Abraham Lincoln to his son's headmaster. When his son was going to the school for the first time. So I'm not going to read the whole letter. Please search it in Google, and it will be surely be helpful for you to read this. So what was the thinking of Abraham Lincoln was that Abraham Lincoln's letter to his son's teacher is full of his optimism and the ethical values he believed in. He asked the teacher to teach his son to have faith in humanity, and teach him not to be discouraged by scandals, selfish politicians, and enemies. For every selfish politician, there is a dedicated hero. He need not condemn all politicians as bad. There may be enemies, but there is a friend for every enemy. Yeah, in today's time, when when I see this Shahrukh Khan's son ka case, I realize that there are two kind of parents, you know. I compare this Abraham Lincoln and Shahrukh Khan. Good parenting knows that it is imperfect and teaches a child to grow by showing that we learn each day how to be better. And bad parenting gives up on itself or its child when things don't go as planned. So there may be enemies, but there is a friend for every enemy. Thus, the equations in life are wonderful. He must learn the dignity of labor and hard work. Here, he should be taught the necessity of undergoing the pain of failure in order to appreciate success. He requests his son to stay away from envy and stay and to enjoy quiet laughter. He wants him to teach his son that bullies accept defeat quickly. He also urges him to teach his son the wonders of reading books and deep quiet reflections on the beautiful mysteries of nature. So this was the letter. These were the beautiful lines which were written by Abraham Lincoln. So one of my favorite lines, see, all the lines are beautiful, but among these, my attention went here is, in the school, teach him, it is far more honorable to fail than to cheat. Teach him to have faith in his own ideas, even if everyone tells him that they are wrong. Teach him to be gentle with gentle people and though with the tough, tough with the tough. Try to give my son the strength not to follow the crowd when everyone is getting on the bandwagon. Teach him to listen to all men, but teach him to also filter all he hears on a screen of truth and take only the good that comes through. The paragraph continued the idea of withstanding failures, beginning with in school. Teach him it is far more honorable. Very few people choose that side in any competition. So most people would rather cheat to gain victory, but the action is the same, meaning as stomping onto its own dignity. And President Lincoln didn't want his son to involve in such actions. In this next few paras, I found one more beautiful line in the end, and it is, teach him to always have sublime faith in himself, because then he will always have sublime faith in mankind. This reminds me of a famous dialogue from the movie Om Shanti Om of Shah Rukh Khan. He says that, kisi bhi cheez ko shiddat se chaho to puri kainat use milane mein lag jati hai. And that's true. That's what Abraham Lincoln told. Ki apne pe bharosa rakho and everyone will gonna trust you. Okay? So, coming on the point, President Lincoln wanted his son to grow up as a gentleman. So he wrote the letter to boy's teacher, to the boy's teacher, in order to indirectly teach him the worthiness of life. Throughout the letter, there were no announcement of the presidential role, but he wrote to the teacher with respect. The letter contains the lesson that existed for hundreds of years, which is still valuable today. These were the famous quotations, which was given by Abraham Lincoln. You cannot escape the responsibility of tomorrow by evading it today. आपको कल के responsibility से भागने के लिए आज तो आप छुप के नहीं बैठ सकते. You have to face it, right? My great concern is not whether you have failed, but whether you are content with your failures. Yes, you should be. Now, here comes the saddest part when I read this. Such a great president died because of this person who killed him. So what was his assassination was, Lincoln was assassinated on April 14, 1865 by well-known actor and Confederate sympathizer John Wilkes Booth at Ford's Theater in Washington, D.C. Lincoln was taken from the theater to a Peterson house across the street and laid in a coma for 9 hours before dying the next morning. His body lay in state at the Capitol before the funeral train took him back to his final resting place in Springfield, Illinois. You can see this picture. This person is shooting on his head, and that's how Lincoln died. this was a reward poster which was kept by the government of America, that कोई भी जो भी you know killer को find करेगा उसको reward मिलेगा. That was $1 lakh. After this, the Lincoln's conspirators execution, various heritage of Abraham Lincoln you can find after when he died, various libraries, school, colleges, more various you know things were made, museums were made on his name, because he was such a great person, right? So finally, what we can actually learn from his life, we can learn to be a self learner. Never stop reading. Try something new. Don't lose your sense of humor. Dare to be different. Now, what these lines explain is that you know, you should also always be a self learner. Lincoln, who spent most of his childhood doing farm work to help out his father, taught himself in school in spare time. He built his own homeschool using books given by his stepmother, neighbors, and teachers, who were all aware of his thirst to learn. He later started reading on law, learning enough to be admitted to the Illinois bar so that he could practice. He never learned a lesson in a law school. Never stop reading. You can study from a book to make sure you can score A on test. You can read one for entertainment. You can also use books and other reading material to keep learning for a lifetime. To sum it up, you can be like Lincoln, who didn't quit his quest for learning, for knowledge, long after he reached many of his goals. Try to do something new. Lincoln embraced the technology that was available to him at that time, which led him to become the first president to use the telegraph, the internet of his days. His students said he used the telegraph to communicate with the journals, much in the way we use email today, right? So follow in Lincoln's step by getting out of your comfort zone to learn new skills or an unfamiliar course. Don't lose your sense of humor. Even under the most challenging and the intense circumstances, Lincoln was known for keeping his sense of humor. During a debate with Stephen A. Douglas, during an Illinois state campaign, Lincoln's opponent accused him of being two-faced, mocking his own looks. Lincoln replied, honestly, if I were two-faced, would I be showing you this one? When studying, don't forget to relax and laugh every once in a while. It will ease the tension. Dare to be different. Lincoln, who was known for his honesty, stood up to the critics and stuck by his beliefs. Lincoln, who failed several times, he failed in the business at the age of 21, who defeated in the legislative race at the age of 22, failed again in the business at the age of 24, lost congressional race at the age of 34, lost again the congressional race in the age of 36, lost senatorial race at the age of 45, failed in an effort to become the vice president at the age of 47, and lost a senatorial race at the age of 47. Lincoln never, he never stopped. He always dared to be different. He always tried. Lincoln, who was known for his honesty, stood up against the critics and stuck by his beliefs. That approach didn't always make him popular. There were even some newspapers, communists, who made fun of his inability to speak good grammar. Like Lincoln, you may run into a share of critics. Stick to what you know is right. You should learn from his story. What Lincoln gave us today is very much precious. At the end, as a member of ELA, we are holding the life lesson from legend session is because even though they have been there many, many years ago, and till today, the stories are very inspiring. You can learn a lot of these from them, and in terms of the values that they have put out. There are so many things that we can implement in our lives today. The idea is that that as to being the youth, we need people to look up to, and we follow their footsteps better than who made several changes in the society, and especially people as recognizable. as Abraham Lincoln, Swami Vivekananda, and Subhash Chandra Bose. And therefore, I, as a student, has taken up to talk about them and to share what I feel as important and how greater impact that they have left to us. Well, that's all my time. Thank you.
Thank you, Yuvraj, and all the others, Riya and Shloka. You have done a very beautiful job. I just hope that all the participants who have been till here in the end also, I...